In this video, we'll talk about convex sets. Convex sets share many similarities with convex shapes. These are shapes which, in some sense, don't turn in on themselves. To understand what that means, compare the convex shapes with non-convex shapes, otherwise known as concave shapes. If you had to write down a mathematical rule for how to tell if a shape is convex, what would it be? Perhaps the best way to tell if a shape is convex is if you choose any two points within the interior of the shape and draw a straight line connecting them. If it is convex, any point along this line will still be inside the shape. It's easy to see that this is not true for concave shapes. Let's talk more generally about convex sets. Note that generally a convex set is a set of vectors or something which can be represented as vectors. This includes coordinates or points in space. In the same way as we've seen for convex shapes, if a set containing two vectors A and B is convex, then it will also contain all the vectors on a straight line between them. We can write these vectors as C equals A plus theta times B minus A, where theta is just a number between 0 and 1. For example, if theta is 0, then C equals A plus 0 times B minus A, which is just A. At the other end of the scale, if theta is equal to 1, then C equals A plus B minus A, which is just B. If theta is somewhere between 0 and 1, we get the vector C somewhere between A and B. For example, if theta is equal to 0.5, then C equals A plus 0.5 times B minus A, which is A plus B over 2, and is directly between A and B. So now we're ready to write down the mathematical definition of a convex set. A set X is convex if for any two elements, A and B in X, then C, which is A plus theta times B minus A, where theta is a number between 0 and 1, is in the set. Here's an interesting property of convex sets I like to call the no holes property. There are never any gaps between the elements in a convex set. To demonstrate this, let's take three elements, A, B and C, of a convex set. Because this set is convex, then the points along the lines connecting them must also be in the set. Now, choose any element within the boundary given by these lines. Let's call it X. We can choose one of our original elements, let's say B, and draw a line through the point X and carry on until it reaches the line at the opposite side. Where the two lines meet, we'll call this point D. Since D is on the line connecting A and C, then D must also be in the set by the rules of convexity. Now we've positioned X on a line between two points in the set, B and D, and so by definition, X must also be in the set. Now, X wasn't special. We could have chosen any point within this shape, and so we've shown that all points within these lines must also be in the set. Let's finish by showing some examples of convex sets. The first borrows from our intuition of convex shapes, and the second might be a little bit more surprising. The first example is a set of all vectors with lengths less than 1. This means all vectors that can be contained in a circle of radius 1. When shown visually like this, we can see that any other vectors on a line connecting them are also in the set. The second example is a set of polynomials of degree 2, or all possible quadratic equations. This is a little bit different because it's infinite in scope, but following the rules, we can show that it counts as a convex set. The elements of the set, y1, y2, etc., can all be written as y equals a plus b x plus c x squared, where the a's, b's and c's are just numbers. If we take two elements from the set, let's say y1 and y2, then we can use the same equation as before to create a new element C, which is y1 plus theta times y2 minus y1, with theta being a number between 0 and 1 like before. Now, if we plug in our equations for y1 and y2, we end up with this horrible equation. But notice these three parts are just numbers, so we can rewrite C as A plus BX plus CX squared, where A, B and C are just the numbers from above. And we've shown that whatever this equation is, it's still just a polynomial of degree 2, and so it's still in our original set.